Let us see another array function in functional style called as reduce. The function name is called as reduce. Just like other array functions, the function reduce takes two arguments, an array and a function. The function reduce, however, returns a single value. So if we are interested with array operations that return a single value, we can make use of reduce in a functional style. For example, say we are interested in the total number of students in a class, or say the average marks of a particular course, etc. Also, the signature of reduce function is little bit different from the other array functions that we have already seen. So the syntax of reduce is reduce that takes in two arguments, array and function that returns a single value. So that is the difference. It looks similar to map and filter, but it is different in this sense. It returns a single value, whereas map and filter returns an array. Also, to the function reduce, we pass a function as the second argument. To this function, which is passed as the second argument, we can pass two arguments. The first one is called as the accumulated value. Let us say, call it as AV. So this is the value that gets accumulated during each iteration or each time the function is called. And the second value is the array element or the current array item. Let us call it as, say, CI, current item. Okay. So this function that returns a value becomes the value for AV the next time this function is called. All right. Also, we can pass a third argument to the reduce function whose value will be the initial value for this argument AV. For example, if we pass in a third argument with the value 0, 0 will be the initial value or the starting value for this first argument AV. Alright, now if a third argument is not passed, by default, the value of AV will be the first item of the array passed to reduce. Alright, so this is the signature or the syntax of the array function reduce. Let us now see an example in JavaScript for this function. Let us say we want to find the average marks of a course in a class. So let's get started by creating an array named as, say, AWT for the course Advanced Web Technologies. So this is an array that has four objects. The first object has name and item. Sorry, name and say marks with the values marks as 90 and the name as say student 1. So let us similarly create three more objects with the following values. Student S2 having marks 80, student S3 having marks 77, and finally student S4 with the marks 82. Alright, so now we have an array for the course AWT with the following information. Alright, now to find the average marks without using procedural style, we can use reduce in a functional style. So let us first include the Lodash library so that reduce is available to this script. So let's do that. So variable underscore equal to require Lodash. So now that the functional library Lodash is available to this script, let us invoke reduce by referring to this script, which is underscore, so underscore dot reduce, and pass in the required parameters. So the parameters are, the first one is the array. So array name is AWT. The second argument is, let us define an anonymous function. So function that returns a single value. So what is that single value? So what do we want to do? We want to find the average marks. So let us first of all pass in the two arguments to this function. So the first value, let us call it as AV, accumulated value. Second argument is CI, that represents the current item. So let us first of all find the sum of all the marks and then divide this by 4, since we have 4 items in this array. So let us say CI dot marks to get the marks and then add it to the accumulated value AV. Now this accumulated value, by default, if we do not give any specific value as the third parameter, by default it is the value of the first element in the array, and all our elements or items in the array are objects. So this doesn't make sense, in the sense ci.marks is an integer and av is an object. So the first item is an object. So object plus integer, we don't want that. Rather, let us have a default value of 0 to av. So let us say 0 as the third parameter to reduce. Alright, so 0 will be the initial value or the starting value to av. So now we are finding the sum of all the marks for the subject AWT. So let us run this program and see if we are getting the sum of marks by calling node test.js. And yeah, we are just returning it, but we need to return this to some name. So let us have a variable, say variable average marks. So we are not at finding the average, we are just testing by testing the sum of all the marks. So let us call it as sum marks, and then do a console.log and print sum marks. Let us run the script now. We get 329. So 329 is the correct answer, as it is the sum of 90 plus 80 plus 77 plus 82. Alright, but we are however interested in the average mark. So what we can do is, to this result what we get, we can divide this result by the length of AWT. So we can call awt.length, awt.length. Alright, so let us save it, run the program again. What we say is 82.25, which is the average marks for the subject AWT. Alright guys, so That is reduce array function in functional style. Thank you.